long ago, back when people had a lot more time, they still made movie trailers.
That's impossible!
And for long video on YouTube, the winning recipe is pack the first 30 seconds with the best drama action to create FOMO. No, you will not be the first to make a teaser preview, and no, AI will not do it for you. But you will be done first. In this video, you will learn how to mark key scenes, consolidate down the best cuts, and then stitch it all together, and you only export once as an MP4 up to 4K, 60 frames per second. Really freaking good quality. Teasers are already the go-to edit on YouTube for interviews, GoPro action, police body cam, reaction videos. Now, for the teaser example for this video, I needed my own content. So I strapped a GoPro onto my dog, play Frisbee for about 30 minutes at the dog park, and of course, get into some dog drama, and make watchable video for YouTube in less time than it takes to record.
Hi, I'm Doug. This is my dog, Shadow. We're at Brummelsick State Dog Park, off-leash dog area. We're gonna go play some Frisbee and have some fun.
Let's do it. By the time you're done marking key scenes for a teaser, you will have cut all the footage, enhanced what you keep, and on the third step, export. All in one pass, you only have to watch your video once, and it's not going to be for cut accuracy. Because TimeBolt uses sound detection, not transcription, you get a base cut that is 20 times more precise. Ends of words don't get cut off, you don't have a sloppy start to cuts. For unscripted video, run uncheck, you can add any unique word tick phrase. So if you are the author of, now there are two of you, the classic, the subtle art of not giving a one for the ladies, fuck Valentine's Day, I love you every day, or my personal favorite, around and find out. You can keep your stuff PG for the kids 75% of the time. It's gonna work every time. Edit anything on the timeline. Just press the space bar, hit the keys SOB. You split the timeline with S, turn scenes on or off with O, and back cut what you just heard with B. You can punch in, zoom around to specific areas, click P or right click. You can fast forward through silence when your goal is to show not tell, up to 4x speed. And on the first pass, type your YouTube chapter markers. As you type these in, when you go to export, they're just gonna copy and paste right into the description of YouTube. This alone will save you the time of having to watch your video again. How beautiful is that? With TimeBolt, you save cuts as a JSON file. A JSON is a simple text file with your cut instructions. It's instant to save, instant to apply. Everything in this video was stitched in TimeBolt. Our segment shot at different times. You no longer have to render a video in TimeBolt and then export to another editor to add a show intro or outro. Now, ladies and gentlemen, follow these steps to create a powerful, engaging teaser. You do need a paid version of TimeBolt. Drop your source file into TimeBolt. Since action video or police body cams have absolutely nothing to do with sound, I put remove silences longer than at 10 seconds. Hit update silence detection, and now automatic cuts are not automatically made. Then, once my video is processed, I set my preview playback to 1.5x speed. And this way, when I press the space bar, it'll start previewing at 1.5x automatically.
Let's go have some fun and play some Frisbee.
There's absolutely no need to ever watch your video at the same speed as real life. As I'm previewing, to mark a key scene, first I'm gonna press S to create a split. I'll wanna keep all this. You press M to mark a key scene. As you can see, a yellow bar is added. Track time as you add new markers here. Each time you add a new marker, you can see what the new duration is or take a marker away. Now, by the time you get done adding markers, you should be done with all of your edits. Save your primary timeline cuts. Now, I'm gonna go in here and rename my JSON to timeline. This way I know which JSON I'm gonna be applying in Stitch after I create the teaser. And now's the time that we wanna consolidate just the marked cuts to save a teaser video. Select keep only marked cuts to consolidate just to the markers. Hit shift plus the down arrow key to get to the beginning of your markers. You can now preview the marked cuts. You hit your space bar and just the marked scenes will be played.
Drop it. Oh my God, he's strong.
That looks exactly like what we want to have. But let's just say we didn't want to have a marker that's there right now. You can't just remove the marker at this phase, okay? You're gonna hit Command Z to undo keep only marked cuts. You're gonna remove the marker, hit M, okay? And now, just like the process that you did before, we're gonna do keep only marked cuts. Shift plus the down arrow key, and we have the end of our teaser. Now it's at this time that we want to save our mark clips, okay? This is the second JSON that we've saved, and this one we're going to rename to teaser because these contain the cuts of just our marked clips, okay? So we have the full timeline and the teaser timeline. Okay, you do have different options when it comes to how you're gonna export a teaser. Advantage here with the JSON, saving the timeline and teaser as a JSON, I'm only gonna have to render the final video once. I could just save out XML once I kept only marked cuts, and as an editor, that would allow me to then export to Final Cut Pro or some other non-linear editor, or maintain control over the timing if I was to give this work to a design editor that I'm working for. So not only am I cutting up my main timeline, I also know what my audience wants to see, and I can still control that timing very time efficient with an XML file. Me personally, sometimes I like to just go ahead and render out the teaser because at this stage I can apply background audio. And so I essentially just add my background audio, select the percentage. I usually choose between 10 to 20% of the background music volume, and hit render. And so that way the teaser also has background audio. So I wouldn't be stitching together a JSON, I'm stitching together an MP4 that's already rendered with my main file. And if you're putting background audio on, it's good to do it at this phase, because now if you apply turbo, what'll happen is TimeBolt will just apply turbo to the teaser, okay? And then overlay and loop the background audio. It also won't speed up the background audio, which can really distort things. Open stitch and add your raw source file. I click apply JSON file. I select the teaser JSON. This means it will just have the cuts. Now this is the JSON of just the highlighted clips that will play. The next video I add is a pre-produced show intro. This is something that was already made in another editing software. Now it's time to add the main timeline. Go back to the raw source video. Again, I'm gonna add the apply timeline JSON file. And so this is the cuts of all the shows. It's a space bar and you can preview the results.
Drop it. Oh my gosh, he's strong. Yeah.
Now, I don't need to right now, but if I wanted to, I could drag to reorder if necessary. But before I rendered, I typed custom YouTube chapters. The teaser JSON still has the YouTube chapters. When I go to download chapters text file, I do not want them associated with the teaser. I'm going to clear chapters from the very first teaser. I'm going to keep my chapters here. See how it says I still could have that option? I'm going to keep my chapters here. And so now all the time markers are going to work out for the YouTube chapters. And obviously, if this was an MP4 where we did add background audio, that would not have any chapters. You would just be able to skip this step. If it's talking video, here you're going to want to apply turbo mode. Who doesn't want to talk 12% faster? But since this is GoPro action, that's not something that this video is going to get. You can apply turbo mode both to a JSON and an MP4. And you would want to make sure to apply it to your main timeline as well if you were using turbo mode. Click export. Download chapters text file. As you can see by this chapters text file, it starts at 44 seconds. It left in the 30 or so seconds for the first teaser and the primary show intro. So as you can see, all the math is going to work out fantastic. Just between you and I, by the time this video comes out, you're going to be able to, right here, add chapter clips to the render queue, and you'll be able to render each video in each chapter as its own MP4 named by that file. So it's the opposite of stitch. It actually deconstructs the entire video into multiple clips. Select the resolution up to 4K, 60 frames per second. Export video. Name the file name. Hit export. While my watchable video is rendering, getting ready to upload to YouTube, I go walk the dog, I do chores. I did all of this in less time than it took to record live. You only have to render once. I hope you have a good computer, because the better it is, the faster this is gonna work. Between you and I, the best part of this is that I recorded these last two segments entirely in TimeBolt. You can open capture here right below stitch, click the capture screen recorder icon. You can fit any size square or rectangle. Why do you even need a circle? Check this out. I can switch cameras mid recording. How cool is that? All right, that's enough playing. Now, if you are new to TimeBolt, please watch our 10-minute tutorial video. I'm linking it to this page, and I'm out of time.